Hello, everyone. Boy, is it chilly here in South Dakota, but no better time of year. Obviously, the Summit League play is in full effect, and we're super excited. Last week was a crazy deal, you know, going 1-1. Certainly was hoping to go 2-0, but our guys had some great resiliency at St. Thomas, and to come away 1-1, you never celebrate that, but you take it and see what you can get better at and move on. And for us, you know, it was really telling, and especially these last two games, that we really, really need to improve on the defensive end of the floor. And, you know, giving up 99 points and to a very good Denver team, but we need a little bit better effort, and that's what we're looking forward to going forward. But we know we have a tough week. Omaha's playing as good as anybody in the league. Very, very confident basketball team. And then same thing with USD. As you guys know, doesn't matter what the records are when you're talking to rivalry games. They're going to be chippy. They're going to be fun. They're going to be engaging. And that's what we got coming up on Saturday.
Zim, if you want to get us started.
Sure.
Hi, Zim.
How you doing?
I'm doing awesome. How are you doing, man? Did you have a good holidays and stuff?
Yeah, I did.
Good.
But otherwise, yeah. you alluded to, you know, needing to get better on defense, but just kind of overall, how are you just feeling about how the team is at right now relative to maybe where you hope to be at this point in the season?
Yeah, I mean, all things aside, I mean, obviously we didn't play our best in Denver, but since Christmas break, I've been really, really pleased with our team. I think our connectivity, our intent has been at a good spot. So I love our progression. I think we're getting better. I think we're close, but we need a little bit more intent, a little bit more urgency, and a little bit more pride on that defensive end of the floor. And that's what we're looking for. We know we're not a finished product. We know, and we're excited about some of the gains that we've made since Christmas time. But we also know that we got a little bit ways to go yet if we want to reach our goals and dreams.
Is that all it is on defense, is just kind of a buy-in thing? Or are there tangible things as far as talking better, maybe just playing more physical? What are things you can do to get better on that end?
I do think it's a combination of it a little bit, to be honest with you, Zim. I think there's some things principle-wise that, you know, I need to look at in what our plan is, what are we giving up, and things like that. So there's certainly some reflection on what I can control, you know, as far as, hey, what is the philosophy? How are we guarding ball screens? How are we guarding in the post? What are we trying to take away? Things like that is certainly being evaluated every single day, you know, and are we putting these guys in a position to be successful? And then I do think there needs to be a little bit more emphasis on my end maybe as well of, hey, defensively, if we're going to make things happen the way we want to, we need to make it more important. We need to value that more. I need to emphasize that more, whether it's our practice plan, whether how we're going about things. So that's, I think, the biggest piece of it. Certainly it's a team game, right? So they need to buy into that as well. And they need to have, hey, that understanding that, to reach our goals, we need to be one of the better defensive teams in the league. And we're not right now. I mean, that's just the reality of it. And so you take a look at all that combined and you try to make changes.
What catches your attention about Omaha? I mean, they're obviously very talented and look like they're playing well, and also USD on Saturday.
Yeah, I think Omaha, when I look at them, I've obviously spent a lot more time on them than the Yotes so far. But, you know, they got great positional size. They brought in, you know, the Davis kid at the five spot, and he is super, super physical and very effective down there. We all know about Frankie and his ability to score the basketball, but he's also averaging 3 assists in the league. And so I just think they're fitting together better. I think they're a little more connected than they've been in the past, and they're playing very, very confident. They believe in each other. They have a great sense of belief, and so that's what catches my eye with Omaha. And then South Dakota, you know, I just think there's still, you know, the Stewart kid has been such a vital part of their success. And, you know, he's battled injury. He's a heck of a player. And the big kid inside has given him a great presence in there that they haven't had in the past. I've seen one game of theirs, so that's really what I have to go by. But he played terrific that game. So I think those are the things, you know, the Stewart kid, not necessarily, but their size, you know, inside in the interior for South Dakota probably seems maybe a little different than it's been in the past.
Thanks, Endo.
Chris, have anything?
Oh, yep. I got a couple of questions for you, Hendrick.
Sounds good, buddy.
Yeah, you've said that to be consistent is the biggest question you guys have faced right now. You talked about kind of tweaking some things and that sort of stuff. But is there a mentality thing that you can kind of use to contribute to finding that type of consistent player you're looking for?
Well, I think that's part of it. You know, there's everybody has a responsibility in it. You know what I mean? You know, I and our staff has responsibility to make sure our guys are connected and hey, what are we going to do in certain situations? And they have to understand, we have to do a good job of teaching that and explaining that so they're connected and they're playing in unison, right? But there is their responsibility as a mentality and a buy-in and a pride and an understanding that we need to play with this level of urgency to be successful. And I have some responsibility with that too, a motivator, you know, an educator at heart. You want guys to enjoy, you want them to have fun, you want them to play free, because when they do that, they play harder. They play more engaged. And so it all goes back to, hey, how are you organizing things? How are you putting things in place to help with that mentality too? They have to, you know, that they can control their attitude and their effort, right? They can control that. And that needs to be consistent. But I have to put them in situations to make sure that I help with that too.
You know, you guys have had 11 games on either neutral or road courts this season and just 7 at home. You get one start of the week, but then you go right back on the road to South Dakota. You know, how difficult has it been to settle into a rhythm with this schedule so far?
It's been hard. I mean, there's no doubt about it. I mean, it was, you know, played a great game on Thursday, fun game. St. Thomas is a really good basketball team that was really well coached. And this, you can say the same for Denver, you know, and the, you know, you travel out there and you're going in the mountains and there's just a lot of different things. But we can sit here and talk about those really, and what they are, their excuses. We're dealing with 20-year-old dudes that love this game. I mean, every opportunity that you get, you got to embrace, you got to love. So to me, it's all about a process. We've been put into some tough spots, and sometimes we've been successful, and sometimes we're going to use them as learning experiences, you know, because we haven't maybe had the outcome that we wanted, but that doesn't mean you can't learn from them. So we put together these schedules on purpose. Some of it's in our control and some of it's not, but I do know one thing: we will never make excuses and we'll always try to learn from every situation we're in.
And the last question I have for you, frankly, Fiddler has played pretty well against you guys in the past. You mentioned his assists were up. What kind of challenges does he bring to you guys on Saturday?
Well, it's a big challenge. I mean, he's got great size, you know, and he's averaging 30 points a game in league play. And so he's playing super, super confident. He's a hard matchup. You know, he can play in multiple areas of the floor. So we're going to have our hands full and we'll mix up who's guarding him. You know, we'll throw some things at him. So we're excited. I mean, we love our team and our team is just, we're not quite where we need to be yet, but we're getting closer. And I love the opportunity to get out on the practice floor with our guys and then try to get better that day. So we're looking forward to this challenge on Thursday against Frankie in Omaha. And we know they've been successful in the start of league play. But you know what? We're ready for the challenge.
Hey, thanks, Hendo. Appreciate it.
You got it, buddy.
Hey, Eric. Thanks for joining us. Do you have anything, Eric, for coming up?
Yeah. Hi, Coach. How are you doing?
Good. How are you, Eric?
Doing well. Thanks. Just with the USD game being on Saturday this week, just how different is that preparation with having a Thursday game when in the past it's been you've had the whole week to prepare for the rivalry?
Yeah, I mean, I still think, you know, obviously both teams will be prepared. And it's hard not to get up for a game like that. So it'll be fun, you know, but we've worked on short preps before. So it's not something totally uncommon for us. And they're in the same boat. They play Thursday at home as well. So it's really similar for both teams. And I'm sure it will be a great environment and a fun game on Saturday.
How have you liked how Luke Apple has reintegrated himself back into the lineup since he was injured last year?
Yeah, Luke obviously is a big part of what we do, and you know, he's had a great approach. And you know what? We needed another scoring presence. And, you know, he's averaging just over double figures, which has been great for us. And I think he's even getting more and more comfortable here since Christmas. So we need him to continue to get better. I know he's an older guy. He's in his sixth year of college. But you never stop learning and you never stop growing. And we need him to continue to do that. And I'm looking forward to for him to even be even a little bit more aggressive here as we end this year.
All right, thanks, Coach.
You got it, pal.
Ian, have anything at all?
Yes. Hey, Hendo, how's it going?
Good. How are you, Ian?
Good.
Good.
Wanted to ask you about, kind of touch on it maybe a little bit with that Luke answer. You have four players averaging double figures this year. Last year just had two. How important is it to kind of have more of that, you know, the depth on the scoring end?
Well, I think you're right. I mean, I think having a balanced scoring attack is put some difficult choices in other teams' pocket, you know, and they have to decide, you know, what they're going to take away and who they're going to take away and how they're going to guard us, because we do have a nice interior presence, and then we also have been shooting it from the perimeter pretty well, you know, very well as of late, and so. You know, it's something that, you know, it's great to have, you know, and that balance is always good. But like I've said before too, Ian, offense is not the issue. I mean, we've been super, super efficient. We've got to find better ways to guard. We need to have a little bit more pride on that defensive end. And I need to put our guys in a little better position as well, to be successful on that end. Offensively, with our balance and our ability to put the ball in the basket, like, not saying that's never going to be an issue, but that's not the problem right now. We need to have more pride on the defensive end, and we need to be able to get stops.
Other than defense, maybe what's one or two things that has stuck out to you of what areas that you can improve?
Turnovers. We have to take care of the basketball better. We've had some careless turnovers, and when we get a shot, we're one of the more efficient teams in college basketball. The problem is we're averaging about 16 turnovers a game, and we need some of those back. You know, obviously we're going to have some with the style of play that we have, and so you can't expect it to go to nothing, you know, but to have it around that 15-16 turnover mark is just too high, and when you're as efficient a basketball team as we are, it's really, really important to get shots, so that's the thing on offensively. We've got to take care of the basketball a little bit better, but we still, you know, guarding and making it tougher for the other team has to be a priority.